Nitrogen makes up 78% of the air, but it exists in a form that cannot be used by plants. So, nitrogen must be reduced to the usable form ammonia. This is called nitrogen fixation. There are only two ways for nitrogen to be fixed into the soil. The first is by lightning, bang. The second is by plants and their associated soil bacteria. Lightning is unreliable to fix nitrogen, and so nitrogen fixation by plants is the most important mechanism. Farmers have long used fertilisers to provide nitrogen to plants. However, using fertilisers is expensive and bad for the environment. So, is there a way to increase nitrogen fixation efficiency in plants without using fertiliser? Legumes have evolved a natural mechanism in which they use a symbiotic relationship with the bacteria Rhizobium leguminosarum to fix nitrogen into the usable form of ammonia. The bacteria R. leguminosarum live in small nodules on the root of the legume plant. R. leguminosarum contain genes to synthesize the enzyme nitrogenase that catalyzes the ATP-dependent reaction of turning nitrogen into ammonia, which the plant uses to grow. In return, the legume provides a home for the bacteria. In 1978, a team of scientists discovered the transmissible symbiotic plasmid of R. leguminosarum, PRLIJ1. When they crossed the PRLIJ1 plasmid with other rhizobium species, the resulting strains were able to nodulate peas. They then used an acetylene reduction assay to test nitrogenase activity and found decreased levels of acetylene in cross strains, indicating that nitrogen fixation was occurring. Therefore, the genes to nodulate and fix nitrogen must be found in the PRLIJ1 plasmid. Transposons integrate DNA fragments into genomic DNA, which causes mutations. The TN5 transposon codes for kanamycin resistance. In 1982, J. Allen Downie used TN5 transposase to confer kanamycin resistance into the PRLIJ1 plasmid of the R. leguminosarum. Downie then identified the TN5 insertion sites by restriction endonuclease mapping, in which restriction endonuclease, an enzyme, cuts the DNA in specific places, in this case at TN5 insertions, to break the DNA up into small pieces. The regions of DNA surrounding the TN5 insertions were put into E. coli plasmids and cloned. Restriction endonuclease mapping of these clones was used to identify two clusters of mutants. The mutant alleles span approximately 45 kilobases of DNA, and so defines the region of the plasmid that contains the fix and nod genes. 9 TN5 insertions into the PRLIJ1 plasmid were identified that affected nitrogen fixation. A further 3 insertions were identified that were unable to nodulate peas. Restriction endonuclease mapping of cloned mutant nodulation strains found that the TN5 insertions occurred in the same place in both strains, which told Downie that the nodulation strains are close together in one region. In 1983, Downie cloned the PRLIJ1 fix and nod genes on a series of overlapping cosmids. A cosmid is a hybrid plasmid that contains a cloning vector and cos sequences for packaging DNA from a different genome into the cosmid. Downie replicated the cosmids and then used colony hybridization, in which DNA probes for fix alleles and nod alleles were used to determine whether the colony contained nod or fix genes. Two colonies contained DNA from a fix allele, and two colonies contain DNA found in a nod allele. When the two colonies with nod DNA were put into non-nodulating mutant strains of R. leguminosarum, nodulation ability was restored, which was demonstrated by a phenotype that formed nodules on peas. These two strains only contained 10 kilobytes of common DNA, so the nodulation genes must be together in this small region of DNA in the PRLIJ1 plasmid. Altogether, Downie used this information to create a map of the PRLIJ1 plasmid, which shows the nod genes between two separate groups of fix genes. Whilst this tells us the structure of the nod and fix genes, it doesn't tell us anything about how they function. So, Downie used a DNA probe to find the region of DNA in the PRLIJ1 plasmid that is the same as the region of DNA that codes for the regulatory gene nifA in Canamoni. The nifA gene activates the fix genes. Similarly, the nitrogenase genes of K. pneumoniae were previously found to be adjacent to the FIX78 allele, so the homologous region of the PRLIJ1 plasmid was also identified. This led to another key discovery, that the activation of nitrogen fixation genes is under the control of a nifA-like gene, and this is conserved among species. Downie's discoveries about how the symbiosis between legumes and our leguminosarum works are the key to unlocking the ability to transfer the capability to fix nitrogen to other crops. This could help farmers to improve agricultural activity and restore poor soils. In this way, Rhizobium bacteria can act as a biofertilizer.